merciful God.
See my life story here. Yeah. Let me put it this way. Initially, when I came to the work, we were two as a set of twins. And I came out first, and my brother came out. But a couple of days after delivery, we lost my brother. And myself also, about my mom said 3 to 5 hours in temper, I gave it up. We were identical. That even the twins out, I mean sorry, the nurses how to know that goes, okay, this is die, this is candy. I gave up the post. And a friend of us came to the hospital to like, he had the gene, greetings and all sorts. Find out why. The problem. She said your twins have come. No more like, really? What really happened? She explained and the man like, no. You should believe in God yourself. Lord will give you these two twins, but not get them back. And the woman prayed for me, and my mom said she prayed for 7 hours, non-stop. And on the dot of the 7th hour, I came back to her. I sneezed about 7 times. And I already got to know, man, this man or this boy is back to life. And everybody was like rejoicing in the world. And this is someone who had died, whereby my skin had already changed. Know that this guy, there's no life in him. And to God be the glory, he gave me the life back. I know there's a reason why God has brought me to life. Because he has a specific plan for me. Well, journey so far, I don't want to say it's God's grace. Because if it's not good, I won't be where I am today. A lot of obstacles, you know, and lows, but God gave me the privilege to overcome them. So it's God's grace all through. And maybe I'll just say a little bit on how I met Mom. Well, the way we met was in the following. And that was during our NYC. While we were serving, we served at on those states. We were just there, you know, normal copper, high copper thing. You never knew key, something will actually spring up from your high thing. It's about rounding off, and this, you know, this magnetic spirit between a male and a female, and the thing brought us together, and we were like, okay, since I like your way of life, and I like it too, let's see if we could give it a try. Within months, and we saw game, we are both serious. We went to God in prayers, and God is like, this is the way for you. And that's how we came together. And to God be the glory, my pretty wife gave me this baby girl, Fever, here. So that was how. Thanks. I studied economics in an institution named Wellspring University in Benin City. And it took me 4 years. Though the 4 years wasn't easy studying economics because economics requires you going extra mile. I did that, very little boy, I came out fine, it's good grades. And for what I'm doing right now, it's not my power, it's through God's grace. I'm the COO of His Majesty Global School. That's the school which God has given to us. And the school is divinely led by the CEO as the owner of the school. Whereby it's time for us to create an environment whereby we have to, you know, rebuild the society. Because it tends to say that the society is falling apart. And where is it falling apart from the youth? Whereby if we do not have this zeal to study anymore. Everybody believes that short waste money. Everybody believes in next to a week or 3 weeks or a month I should have money at my fingertip. But it's not so. So that is the reason why the school was brought to place. And I'm the CEO of the school, and also I manage a little business alongside with that. My advice for the youth out there is we should always pray that in the back of our mind that there are no shortcuts to success. There's this thing my dad to say always, he tells me, be the best at every point, anywhere, at any given time you can be. And I will also say this to the youth out there, that we should be the best at any point, at any time, at any given time or place we find ourselves. Because you might not know where this will actually take you to. Just be the best you can be. That's my advice to you. Well, our time is back there. First of all, I'd like to make a shout out to my beautiful queen seated here, because she has been a supportive woman to me, made life easy for me. To my baby girl also, big shout out to her. To my parents, to our friends out there, you know, my friends in Benin, where we school then, friends at where we served, in Tabolu, in those states, and the ones near far also, a big shout out to them all. And most importantly, to see you, Africa.
He was used to do like this. To me, no one got glory, honor, and adoration. Now, my own little advice to the youth out there is for me. I don't want us to despise the little we have, as you don't know where the little is taking you to. You don't know what the little could become in the nearest future. I have a lot of friends who will say, I don't have time, I don't want to get married because I don't have money. I don't have money at all. I'm only working here, they're giving me 20,000 naira per month. I don't have some money to give family, but well, contrary to what we're thinking, if it is actually God's will that you should be hooked that particular year, then I know for sure it will definitely provide. It's going to just make everything so easy for you. So, in short, do not despise the little. Thank you very much.
And do you have any special thing to say for him?
Well,
to him?
Yes, because then it's been, I pray that I ask God for a lot of things. That by this time next year, it's going to be a big one. Probably to not be here, some higher places, and I believe God is taking us there so. Thank you very much.
Ibo kebodo mi, kujako jasoli aso. Ibo kebodo mi.